Now I welcome you all for the most interesting part of this schedule, quiz competition for undergraduates. It is a honor to welcome our quiz master Dr. Yamini Kannappan, Dr. Gopinath and Dr. V. Murugavel. We welcome you the dice guild. Dr. Yamini Kannappan, diplomat in National Board of Examination Psychiatry, won the Professor Sarita Menon Gold Medal, a familiar quiz master and a consultant psychiatrist at Cauvery Hospital, Chennai. He was Kankava of Health and Well-being Tamil Nadu, Indian Women Network. He has won many awards for her excellence in psychiatry and addressed numerous scientific sessions. She is very active in television, radio and social media in creating mental health awareness. Dr. S. Gopinath is a consultant psychiatrist with 8 years of experience in psychiatry. He has gained good work experience in the field of psychiatry from the most renowned institutes of South India, namely NIMHANS and JIPMER. His area of interest are adult psychiatry, de-addiction and neuropsychiatry. He has specialized in pregnancy and postpartum mental health. We welcome you, sir. Dr. V. Murugavel has completed DNB psychiatry, DPM, MBBS, worked as a psychiatrist in PsychMed Hospital, Chennai, consultant psychiatrist in Mind Care Clinic, Chennai, and currently working as psychiatrist in ESIC Medical College and Hospital, Chennai from 2020. We welcome you, sir. Now the session is over to the chairperson.
Yeah, thank you. So again, once again, on behalf of the IPSACON quiz committee, I welcome all of you who are present here, my respected professors, all the participants and all those who have joined us in the hybrid mode. I welcome all of you. So now the rules have all been explained to the participants and we are going to go straight to the quiz. And we have 5 teams participating here physically, 4 teams and 6 teams which are joining us virtually. So, shall we get started? Yes. As we said, 7 rounds first, followed by a rapid fire round. So those who are participating virtually, please be alert. If you log out in between, then you might have great difficulties. So please be very, very vigilant. I request silence here while we are starting. Yeah. So now the question. The first round is going to be the clinical psychiatry round, and here we are going to start in a clockwise manner. So the question will be to team 1 first, and if they do not answer, the question goes to team 2. So please remember your pass order. Okay. The first question to team 1. A 5-year-old is being evaluated for ADHD. We'll go to the first question, please. A 5-year-old is being evaluated for ADHD. He has a past history of failure to thrive and is still at the 15th percentile for weight and height. The evaluator notices that the child has an unusually small eyes with short palpable fissures as well as a thin upper lip with a smooth philtrum. Which substance did his mother most likely abuse during pregnancy? Your options, team 1, are A, heroin, B, cannabis, C, alcohol, or D, cocaine. Team 1.
Well, C, alcohol.
Alcohol is indeed the right answer. Team, well done to you. That's the fetal alcohol syndrome. So, very good. Now, the next question is to team 2. A 28-year-old woman comes to the physician requesting genetic counseling. Her father had been diagnosed with Huntington's disease. What is this woman's risk of developing this disease? Your options are A, 1 in 2, B, 1 in 16, C, 1 in 32, or D, she will not develop the disease but will be a carrier. What are your options? What is your right answer? Team 2. Team
Ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Option B, she will not develop the disease but will be the carrier.
What was your answer? Sorry, can you repeat it?
Option D, ma'am.
Option D is the wrong answer. And this question will not be passed since it's a multiple choice question. So the right answer is the first one, A, 1 in 2. So Huntington's disease is an autosomal dominant condition and it is due to an inherited defect in a single gene. So that's a 50% chance. So anyway, don't get disheartened, team 2. We have more rounds. Now, the question to team 3. A 70-year-old man with a dementing disorder dies in a car accident. During the previous 5 years, his personality had dramatically changed and he had caused much embarrassment to his family because of his intrusive and inappropriate behavior. Pathological examination of his brain shows frontotemporal atrophy, gliosis of the frontal lobes, white matter, characteristic intracellular inclusions and swollen neurons. Amyloid plaques and neurofibrillary triangles are absent. Which of the following is the most likely diagnosis? Is it A, Alzheimer's disease, B, Pick's disease, C, Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, or D, B12 deficiency dementia? Team 3, what is your answer?
Option B, Pick disease.
Pick disease is indeed the right answer. That was very characteristic of frontotemporal dementia. Well done, team 3. Now, over to team 4. A young woman presents to the emergency room vomiting bright red blood. Once she is medically stable, the intern who performs her physical examination notices that the enamel of her front teeth is badly eroded and her parotid glands are swollen. Which of the following best describes the source of these medical complications? Your options are A, inadequate caloric intake, B, purging, C, laxative abuse, or D, diuretic abuse. Team 4.
B, purging.
Purging is indeed the right answer. And just to ask, what made you diagnose that?
She's a young woman, so more common for bulimia nervosa.
Yes. So the bright red vomit is because of the Mallory-Weiss tear, which can happen in the esophagus due to vigorous vomiting. And very commonly, erosion of the front teeth happens and parotid gland swelling. So well done, team 4. Now, over to team 5 who have joined us virtually. The question to you is, a 22-year-old Asian woman becomes flushed and nauseated immediately after drinking half a glass of wine. She is noted to have slurred speech, ataxia, and nystagmus as well. She is brought to the emergency department by her concerned friends. Which of the following is the most likely diagnosis? And your options are A, panic disorder, B, histrionic personality disorder, C, factitious disorder with physical symptoms, and D, alcohol intoxication. Your answer, team 5?
Ma'am, can you repeat that?
The question is?
The options?
The options are A, panic disorder, B, histrionic personality disorder, C, factitious disorder with physical symptoms, and D, alcohol intoxication.
Ma'am, D, alcohol intoxication.
Alcohol intoxication is indeed the right answer. Well done, team 5. This is called the Asian flush syndrome because it is noted that the Asian population can have a deficiency of the alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. So that's the right answer. Well done, team 5. Now over to team 6. A 9-year-old boy is brought to the outpatient department with complaints of repeated shrugging movements at the shoulder. His mother says that she first observed this behavior 1 year ago and it follows a fluctuating course. On questioning, the boy says he feels some uneasiness if he doesn't move his shoulder often. The boy is otherwise healthy, playful, and has attained all milestones normal for his age. What is the most probable diagnosis? And your options are A, juvenile myoclonus, B, Tourette syndrome, C, West syndrome, and D, late onset autism. What is your answer, team 6?
A, Tourette syndrome.
Tourette syndrome is indeed the right answer. Well done, team 6. Over to team 7. The team 7 is here physically. So, gridiron abdomen is the term given to multiple abdominal scars that are usually present in patients suffering from one of the below, which is that A, Munchausen syndrome, B, anorexia nervosa, C, somatoform pain disorder, or D, irritable bowel syndrome. Team 7.
Ma'am, option A, Munchausen syndrome.
Yes, Munchausen syndrome is indeed the right answer. Factitious self-imposed disorder. They have multiple scars on the abdomen. So, just a technical problem. Can the lights be on?
No, it's
going to. Okay, fine. So, you'll have to get adjusted to the flickering lights. Now, team 8. All of the following statements about koro are true except A, it refers to shrinking of the penis, B, occurs among men from India, South China and Japan, C, it is a culture-bound syndrome, or D, also called phobia of interpersonal relations.
Option D, ma'am, also called phobia of interpersonal relations.
Absolutely right, team 8, you are right. So the false answer there was it is not the phobia of interpersonal relationships. Very good. And now we have the last two questions of the round of clinical psychiatry. Over to team 9, which is present here. According to Jelinek's classification, gamma type refers to A, malignant alcoholism, B, dipsomania, C, spree drinking, or D, psychological dependence. Team 9, you've got 20 seconds left to answer.
Option A, ma'am.
Option A is indeed the right answer, malignant alcoholism. You took time there to answer, but you came up with the right answer. Very well done, team 9. And now for the last question of the clinical psychiatry round to team 10. Franz Alexander gave prominence to the holy seven psychosomatic diseases, which include all except A, essential hypertension, B, rheumatoid arthritis, C, ulcerative colitis, or D, vascular headache. Team 10. Team 10, your time is...
Vascular headache.
Your time is up. Your time is up. It passes to team 1.
B, vascular headache.
Yes, vascular headache is the right answer. Well done, team 1. So please be vigilant about your time there. So now at the end of the clinical psychiatry round, we'll have Dr. Murugavel tell us which team is leading.
Yes. At the end of round 1, team 1 leads with 30 points, which is Pushpagiri Medical College from Kerala. And team 2 and team 10 yet to open their accounts. Other teams are in 20 points.
Well done, teams. You have more rounds, so don't get disheartened. And well done to the teams who have scored high. Continue your mark bank. Do more. Now, shall we go to the second round? The second round is going to be the psychopathology round. And here again, we are going to have most of the questions are going to be multiple choice questions. Okay? Now, the first question, this is going to start with team 10, anti-clockwise. Okay. Team 10, your first question. Look at the sample there. Person 1 says, how many legs does a cat have? And the person 2 says 3. This sample of speech is indicative of a syndrome which is considered to be a rare form of dissociative disorder in which the individuals give approximate answers to simple questions. Name the syndrome. Team 10, name this syndrome.
Perseveration.
Perseveration is the wrong answer. The question passes to team 9.
Ganser syndrome.
Ganser syndrome is the right answer. The syndrome of approximate answers. That's extremely the right answer. Now, the question to team 9. A 45-year-old man with a chronic psychotic disorder is interviewed after being admitted to a psychiatric unit. He mimics the examiner's body posture and movements during the interview. Which of the following terms best characterizes this patient's symptom? Your options are A. Logoclonia, B. Palilalia, C. Echolalia, or D. Echopraxia.
It's option D, ma'am. Echopraxia.
Echopraxia is the right answer. Well done, team 9. And now we move on to team 8 virtually. A 45-year-old man with a diagnosis of paranoid schizophrenia is asked about his personal background. He replies to each question by providing a wealth of information, some of which is only loosely related to the question asked. It is difficult to persuade him to get to the point and to elicit the complete history, although eventually he does meaningfully answer each question. Which term most accurately describes this phenomenon? Your options are A. Tangentiality, B. Circumstantiality, C. Loosening of association, or D. Derailment.
Option D. Circumstantiality.
Yes, team 8, you are right. Circumstantiality is the right answer. You observed well and you answered right. Now, the question to team 7. A 54-year-old man with paranoid schizophrenia becomes highly agitated in the ward. You are asked to assess him, but he refuses to come to an interview room. He speaks loudly and you can make out his words. However, you cannot elicit any connection between his thoughts. His speech seems jumbled and contains words such as wigwag and homotapian. Which term most accurately describes his behavior? And your options are A. Tangentiality with speech invention, B. Derailment with neologisms, C. Thought insertion with dysphasia, or D. Thought withdrawal with pressurized speech.
Ma'am, option B. Derailment with neologisms.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Derailment with neologisms is the right answer. Well done, team 7. Now over to team 6. A 65-year-old woman tells you at the outpatient clinic that her husband has been replaced by a double. He looks the same as her husband and shares the same mannerisms as him. But in her view, it is certainly not her husband. How would you best describe her beliefs? A. Othello syndrome. Is it B. Delusional infidelity? Is it C. Capgras syndrome? Or is it D. Fregoli syndrome? Team 6.
Capgras syndrome.
Capgras syndrome is indeed the right answer. There is no quiz complete without this. So that's the imposter syndrome and you got it right. Now over to team 5. A 57-year-old man believes the electricity company is persecuting him by sending error messages on a website and by making the lights flicker on and off at night. As there is no evidence, his wife initially does not believe him, but over time comes to share his belief. And what is this phenomenon called? Your options are A. Folly ado, B. Delusions of control, C. Delusional interpretation, or D. Fregoli syndrome. Team 5.
A. Folly ado.
Yes, folly ado is the right answer, and this is when I said that undergraduates are very well versed in psychiatry. Your psychopathology is excellent. So I think all of you have scored so far the right answers. Okay. Now over to team 4. A 23-year-old man describes hearing voices inside his head talking about him. They say things like, I think he should harm himself, and also argue between themselves. He cannot dismiss the voices at will, and the voices seem real. How would you describe this symptom? And your options are A. Is it a pseudo hallucination? B. A third person auditory hallucination? C. Running commentary? Or D. Illusion? Team 4. Yes, third person auditory hallucination is indeed the right answer. Well done there. Now, over to team 3. This is a single word answer. Name this phenomenon which is characterized by compulsive fascination with and performance of repetitive mechanical tasks such as assembling and disassembling, collecting or sorting household objects. It is commonly seen in chronic amphetamine users and cocaine users. What is this phenomenon, team 3? Four seconds there to answer. Time up for team 3. The question passes to team 2. 5 seconds.
Ma'am, is it obsessive compulsive disorder?
No, team 2, that's not the right answer. The right answer is called punding. P-U-N-D-I-N-G. Okay? That's the right answer. Fine. We go on to team 2. This is going to be a multiple choice question. Carpologia or flocculation is A. Picking movements on clothes and bedsheets, B. Uttering obscenities, C. Repeated oscillating movements of the wrist, or D. Flinging movements of feet on the bed.
Option A. Picking movements on clothes and bedsheets.
Yes, absolutely right there, team 2. So in Latin, floccus means a piece of wool, and here flocculation is commonly seen in patients with delirium. Yes, you are right there. And now the final question of the psychopathology round goes to team 1. A 19-year-old college student who has been drinking and taking drugs regularly for several weeks is admitted to the hospital feeling unwell. Within a day, he develops the sensation of insects crawling inside his skin. What is the correct term for this symptom? A. Is it synesthesia? B. Reflex hallucination? C. Kinesthetic hallucination? Or D. Formication? Team 1?
Ma'am, B. Formication.
Yes, formication is the right answer. Well done, team 1. So otherwise, it's also seen in methamphetamine abuse and called the meth mites. So we've come to the end of round 2, and over to Dr. Gopinath and Dr. Murugavel on who's leading.
Team 9 and team 1 is in the leading actually with 50 points, followed by team 5, 6, 7 and 8 with 40 points each, and team 2 and 3 with 20 points. The team 10 is set to open their account. Thank you.
So well done, teams. We still have more rounds. You can definitely catch up. And now we move on to an interesting round, round 3, which is called connections. So basically here, we've got 10 questions in total. The first 5 questions are going to be about psychometric tests. We are going to show an image which will contain 2 clues for a psychometric tool. You have to give us the name of the psychometric test, which is based on the picture clues. Is that okay? Yes. And this is going to start clockwise. So the first question will be to team 1. And the first 5 will be psychometric tests. And the next 5 will be this, which I explained to you earlier. There will be 2 picture clues and you will have to tell. For example, we'll have to say that Aaron Beck, he discovered the triad, cognitive triad of depression. Is that okay? This is a sample question. Now, shall we start the connections round? The first question to team 1. What is this psychometric test? There are 2 picture clues, easy clues. You still have 27 seconds to answer. Team 1. Identify and name the psychometric test.
ABC model.
No, that's not the right answer. The question passes on to team 2. 5 seconds there, team 2.
Asthma.
Okay, so nobody got it right there. So that's the Iowa gambling tasks. So the clue was, we gave you the Iowa city. which was very obvious. And then there's that deck of cards. So the Iowa gambling tasks is basically a test, a psychometric test to look about decision making skills. So that's the four deck of cards which are presented virtually. So that's it. Now we go over to team two, where you have to identify again what is this psychometric test, the name of the test, and you have clues on your screen. Take a wild guess.
Wisconsin card test.
Absolutely right there, team two. That was the Wisconsin card sorting test. Excellent. Now we move over to team three. Identify this psychometric test. Seconds there to go, team three. Identify this psychometric test. You still have time, you can think. 15 seconds more.
Just say something or to pass.
Your time is up, team three. The question is passed to team four.
It's a childhood thematic perception test.
Yes, that's the children's apperception test, CAT. So here you can see the clues were there. So in the original version, we have 10 cards. So basically for children, this is a projective test. So we have animals depicted in social context. So that's right, team four, you got it right. And now the direct question to team four. Identify this common psychometric test. Take a wild guess. If you get the first thing right, you will get it. Eleven seconds more, team four.
Is it Bender-Gestalt test?
No, I'm afraid that's the wrong answer. We move on to team five. The question is passed to you. 5 seconds there.
I'm a Crowell's test.
Sorry?
Crowell's test.
No, that's not the right answer, team five. The right answer is Raven's progressive matrices, which is a non-verbal test of intelligence. So nobody got it right there. Now over to team five, the last question in the psychometric test round. Identify this commonly used psychometric tool. Seconds there for you, team five. Team five?
Unable to see the read that image.
You have to zoom in. 2 seconds there, team five. The question passes to team six. 5 seconds.
The Minnesota multiphasic personality inventory.
Absolutely right, team six. That was the MMPI, which is a common test of adult personality and psychopathology. You got it right. Well done. Now we move on to the second half of the connections round, where you'll be shown a picture. It's not psychometry, but yes, this is question to team six. What is the connection here? There are two parts to the answer. Even if you say one, you get half a point. What is the connection between?
Mom?
Yes. Yes?
Mom, Sigmund Freud.
No, I'm afraid you're wrong. Team six, that's not the right answer. The question passes to team seven. Team seven?
Kurt Schneider.
No, you got it wrong there. So the right answer is, that was Emil Kraepelin. And here what was depicted is his contribution towards the classification of psychiatric disorders. That's why we put up the common classificatory systems of ICD and DSM. So before Emil Kraepelin, it was a unitary concept of mental illness, but after the Kraepelinian concept, the dichotomy came in, and which is still valid today, about the schizophrenia and the manic depressive psychosis. So that was a connection. You were supposed to answer Emil Kraepelin and the classification of mental illnesses. Okay, over to team 7. What is the connection? Identify that. This is again Bhupata.
Ma'am, the picture.
Yes, team 7.
What is happening on the other side? We can't see it, it's not clear.
That's the clue. You'll have to decipher it. What do you think is happening? And who is this person? You have 20. I think the timer has stopped. Timer. Yeah, please. Yes?
Lobotomy, I guess.
Once. No, that's not the right answer, team 7. The question passes to team 8.
Philip Fennell, ma'am.
Absolutely. And what is happening in the picture?
Moral therapy.
Moral intent therapy.
Yes? Can you repeat it? Philip Fennell is indeed the right answer. What is happening in the second picture?
Moral therapy for insanity. Insane.
Yes? Can you repeat it?
Moral therapy for insane.
Oh, moral therapy for insane. You're absolutely right there, team 7, right? Team 8. Team 8, you got it right. That was Philip Fennell, and that is the unchaining of mentally ill patients. And he was the first one to do that. And that was called the treatment, the moral treatment. Mm-hmm. And that's excellent. So now the question is to team 8. Team 8, what is happening in the picture? Who is that? What is the connection? Take your time.
Hugo Serlitti.
ECT, ma'am.
Be loud and clear.
Hugo Serlitti.
Yes.
Electroconvulsive therapy.
Absolutely right, team A, very well prepared. That was Hugo Serlitti, who invented the electroconvulsive therapy, and you have answered so well. Who along with him did the first ECT?
Binny.
Yes. No added points, but that was superlative performance, that along with Lucio Binny. Excellent, team 8, kudos to you for finding it out. Now over to team 9. Your picture clue. An interesting picture clue, that is. Team 9, 28 seconds to go.
Conditioning, ma'am. Classical conditioning by Pavlov. Skinner.
No. That is not the right answer. Team 10.
Ma'am, B.F. Skinner, operant conditioning.
No, that's not the right answer, but we'll give half points to team 9. There was classical conditioning there, but that was John Watson, the father of behaviorism, and that was the controversial little Albert experiment. And if you'd see, just for the undergraduates to know, that was a 9-month-old boy, real boy, whom Dr. John Watson conducted his experiment. So if you see in the first picture, the little boy, 9 months old, was not scared when he was introduced to a white rat. But the second, what they do is they pair. Every time the boy was exposed to the white rat, there was a loud noise which was made by a hammer on an iron pipe, and following which he developed a fear. So that's the classical conditioning which occurs. And then finally, overgeneralization to anything which is white and furry. There was a lot of controversies because it was done on an actual little boy. We really don't know what happened to little Albert then and how he came out of the fear. So we give you half points there because you mentioned classical conditioning. And now for the final question of this round, which goes to team 10. Team 10, what is the connection in this picture? ...26 seconds there to answer. ...14 seconds, 13 there. Yes, your clock is ticking. Team 10, make a wild guess. This is a two-part question. Your time is up. The question passes to team 1. Team 1.
Hanuman therapy.
Hanuman therapy. Is that your answer?
Yes, ma'am.
That was the Hanuman complex which was described by Professor N.N. Wigg. No, because Hanuman is an easy clue. If you should have answered complex, so we can't give you there. So I think this is very interesting to note. It is our own Indian psychiatrist, Professor N.N. Wigg, who came up with the concept of the Hanuman complex and also the Abhimanyu complex. So here he took correlations from the Ramayana, and he said Jambavan is the one who tries to make Hanuman understand the powers that he had forgotten because of a curse. And we as mental health experts, we should be the Jambavan in trying to bring out the powers which is hidden. So that was Professor N.N. Wigg and the Hanuman complex. Nobody scores there. So now we shall look at the scores at the end of round 3.
At the end of round 3, team Maharaja Institute of Medical Sciences from AP leads by 70 points. And the second position is from Medicity Institute of Medical Sciences, Telangana, 60 points.
Excellent, excellent there. So there are still more rounds to catch up. So gear up, all of you. Now, shall we move on to round 4? This is a psychology round, and we are going to start in the anti-clockwise direction, and there are going to be multiple choice questions, and we won't be having passes. Okay? Yes. The first question is going to go to team 10. A 3-year-old boy stands on one side of a large sculpture and is asked to describe what he sees. When asked to describe what a person on the other side of the sculpture sees, the child answers that the other person sees just what he does. Which of the following theories uses the concept described above? Is it A, psychosocial development, B, moral development, C, cognitive development, or D, social development? Team 10, what is the right answer?
C, cognitive development.
Yes, C is cognitive development. So this is the concept of egocentrism, which was given by Jean Piaget, which is part of the pre-operational state. Very well done, team 10. The question to team 9. Team 9, the second question. A woman has had a verbal altercation with a boss at work. She meekly accepts his harsh words, but that night she picks a quarrel with her husband. Which of the following defense mechanisms is being used by this woman? Is it A, displacement, B, acting out, C, reaction formation, or D, projection? Team 9, what is your answer? 10 seconds there. Think.
Ma'am, option A.
Option A, displacement is the right answer. That was the defense mechanism. So on a lesser threatening target when the emotions are poured on. Yes, that's right. Now, for the next question to team 8. A writer of mystery novels who has never had legal problems jokes about his dark side and his hidden fantasies about leading an exciting life of crime. Which of the following defense mechanisms is being used by this man? Is it A, sublimation, B, identification with the aggressor, C, introjection, or D, distortion? Team 8.
Option A, sublimation.
Sublimation is the right answer, team A, where socially unacceptable, where objectionable impulses are conveyed through socially accepted means is sublimation, which is what the writer of this mystery novel did. Very well done, team 8. Now over to team 7. A 45-year-old man accidentally crashes into another vehicle. He feels extremely guilty, and in order to avoid these feelings of self-reproach, he explains in meticulous detail to anyone listening to all of the steps leading up to his accident. Which of the following defense mechanisms is this patient displaying? A. Is it sublimation? B. Intellectualization? C. Acting out? Or D. Rationalization? What is your option, team 7?
Ma'am, option D, rationalization.
No, that's not the right answer, team 7. The right answer is intellectualization. So here the person is intellectualizing, but he tries to explain. So there is a subtle difference between both. So intellectualization was the right answer. Now, team 6. When Miss S first saw a violent movie, she was scared and disgusted. But now she has seen several such movies and she is barely affected by them. S has experienced. Your options: A. Habituation, B. Displacement, C. Catharsis, or D. Adaptation. Team 6. Seconds there, team 6.
Ma'am, adaptation.
Adaptation is the wrong answer. There are no passes. The right answer here is habituation. And that is why we say constant watching of violent movies. That's why mental health experts constantly discourage that, because of the process called habituation. Now, over to team 5. We have the 6th question here. The psychotherapist recommended the procedure of systematic desensitization to Miss R for overcoming her fear of cats. The psychotherapist recommended A. A classical conditioning procedure, or B. An operant conditioning procedure, or C. A backward conditioning procedure, or D. A forward conditioning procedure. Team 5, your option. Five seconds there.
A classical conditioning.
Yes, you're right. Team 5, that was the classical conditioning procedure. We move on to question number 7 to team 4. Mr. A gets annoyed when his mother nags him to do his homework. When he finally does it, his mother stops nagging. Now he does the homework without any nagging. Here, nagging has served as A. Punishment by application, B. Positive reinforcement, C. Negative reinforcement, or D. Punishments by removal. Team 4, your clock is ticking. No, I'm afraid that's the wrong answer, team 4. The right answer is negative reinforcement. Now, over to team 3 for the 8th question of this round. Which school of psychology always emphasized whole patterns rather than elements? Your options are A. Behaviorism, B. Gestalt psychology, C. Structuralism, or D. Adlerian psychology. Team 3. Fifteen seconds there, team 3.
C. Structuralism.
No, I'm afraid that's the wrong answer, team 3. The right answer was Gestalt psychology, to see whole patterns rather than elements. Now we come to the second last question of the psychology round to team 2. An 18-year-old girl comes to the psychiatrist because she pulls out her hair in patches when she is anxious or upset. She is taught to make a tight fist whenever she has this impulse rather than pull out her hair. Which of the following techniques is this? Is it A. Extinction? Is it B. Simple conditioning? Is it C. Desensitization? Or is it D. Habit reversal training? Team 2.
Ma'am, option B, habit reversal training.
Yes, you're right, team 2. That was habit reversal training. Well done there. And now we are going to close the psychology round with the last question to team 1. An adult patient in a medical ward may start to insist to be examined by one particular doctor and feels that the same doctor comes to his bed first and wants to spend longer time in the company of that doctor. The doctor, on account of his physical appearance, mannerism or personality and qualities, reminds the patient of his or her father. This is explained by the phenomenon of options are A. resistance, B. transference, C. confidentiality, or D. counter transference. Team 1.
B. transference.
Transference is the right answer. Well done, team 1. We come to the end of the psychology round and over to the scores.
So the current scoring is like Maharaja Institute of Medical Sciences leads the scoreboard, followed by Medicity Institute of Medical Sciences.
Well done there. We still have more rounds. Gear up. Now next we come to an interesting round, the spotter round. You're going to have picture clues. Observe the pictures very, very carefully. And some of the pictures can have two parts to the answers where you will be scored 10 and 10. And it is going to be a pass round. So we are going to start it clockwise. Team 1, are you ready for your first spotter? Identify this autosomal dominant genetic disorder characterized by a clinical triad of seizures, mental retardations, and facial lesions. Your answer, team 1.
And tuberous sclerosis.
Tuberous sclerosis is the right answer. Well done, team 1. You've started this spotter round on a very, very good note. That was tuberous sclerosis. And you can see the adenoma sebaceum lesions on the face there. Now, over to team 2. There are two questions here. Identify this catatonic sign and also the person who first described it. Team 2. Nineteen seconds. Your clock is ticking, team 2.
Ma'am, it is posturing that was described by Ewald Hecker.
That was described by?
Ewald Hecker.
You got one part of the answer right, that was posturing. So you get half there. The question passes to team 3. Name the person who described catatonia.
Kolbam.
Yes, the full name please. You said something.
Kolbam.
No, Karl was right, but it was not Karl Berg. It was Karl Ludwig Kolbam. So.
Ma'am, she said Kolbam.
Okay, so that's why we said please be loud and clear. We'll give it there. So, please be loud and clear. So both the teams get half points there. That was very well done by the teams. Now this next, it goes to team 3. Look at this MRI, which shows a potentially reversible syndrome, and you'll have to name the syndrome. Team 3. What is that syndrome? 30 seconds there.
Markova-Begnami syndrome.
No, that was a wild guess, I think. So, we pass the question to team 4.
Normal pressure hydrocephalus.
Absolutely right. And why team 4? You've got the right answer, but do you want to explain to us?
The ventricles are enlarged.
Absolutely. The ventricular megaly is very, very obvious. So, out of proportion. So, that was normal pressure hydrocephalus. And the other clue was that was a potentially reversible syndrome. So, look at the clues. Listen carefully. Now, over to team 3 for your question. Team 4. This picture shows two facial features classically considered diagnostic of melancholic depression. You'll have to name the two signs. They carry 10 marks each.
Omega sign and Varagut sign.
Excellent. And you're going to explain to us what they are. You get marks. Don't worry. But Omega sign is
omega
what?
Omega sign is the one seen in the forehead because of continuous frowning of the forehead muscles.
Yes. So that's the vertical wrinkling of the portion between the eyebrows, and it is connected by a horizontal crease on the top. That's the omega sign, and the Verrugut's fold, for those who do not know.
On the upper eyebrows, there's the leg pattern.
The palpebral fold, which goes diagonally, which medially goes upwards. These are the two classical signs, and excellent. Team 4, you did very, very well. And now, over to Team 5 for your picture clue. Observe this very carefully. The pictures hold useful diagnostic clues of a psychiatric disorder. Name the disorder.
Trichotillomania.
Yes, Team 5. And do you want to tell us why you thought, why it is trichotillomania? You got the points already?
Ma'am, there is asymmetric hair loss is seen, ma'am.
Excellent. That's an uneven stubble. And?
There are perifollicular hemorrhages can be there sometimes when the pulling happens.
Okay, excellent. Yes. Yes. Anything more? Right. You are right.
And blunt ends are seen, ma'am. Some?
Okay. And the picture on the right, that's actually the Fryer tuck sign, because very commonly there's a tonsure pattern of alopecia where the patients pull their hair on the vertex of the scalp. So you see some uneven long hairs on the occiput. So there was a Fryer tuck sign, and that was uneven stubble. So Team 5, absolutely trichotillomania was the right answer. Now, over to the next interesting picture clue for Team 6. Name this phenomenon, which is the tendency to perceive a meaningful image in a random or ambiguous visual pattern. Here you can see a face in a cloud. So what is this called? Team 6, 15 seconds there. Your clock is ticking. 7 seconds there.
Ma'am, periodontia.
Yes, can you repeat it? We'll give it to you.
Pareidolia.
We'll give it to you. Pareidolia was the right answer. Pareidolia is a very common phenomenon. It's a very unusual illusion, because the more you look at it, the more you can see. This is all other illusions are vice versa. So that was the face pareidolia. So that was extremely right. Team 6, even though you took a lot of time, you came up with the right answer just on time to score. Now, over to Team 7 for your picture clue. This picture holds a clue for a kind of visual hallucination that has been described in patients with substance use disorders, psychotic disorders, and brain tumors. Name the visual hallucination. What is it called? Team 7.
Lilliputian hallucination.
That was easy, I guess. Lilliputian hallucinations is indeed the right answer. Now, over to Team 8. Identify this historic surgical procedure of drilling holes into the skull to treat abnormal behavior by supposedly letting the evil spirits out. What is this procedure called? Team 8. Team 8. 18 seconds there. Ten more seconds. And your time is up. The question passes to Team 9.
Lobotomy.
Lobotomy is not the right answer. The audience, you want to answer? Quick. Sorry. Louder? No, that was trephination. Trephination was the right answer. Okay, over to Team 9 for your second last question of the spotter picture round. This picture, Team 9, depicts a sign which is typically present in a psychiatric disorder. Name the sign. Name the sign and the disorder. There are two parts to the question.
In bulimia nervosa.
Yes.
Russell Singh.
Absolutely right. Team 9, you are right. You got both the parts of the question right. You want to explain why it's Russell sign?
Like in purging, he will keep his wrist inside mouth. So,
yeah. Right. The constant, because they try to induce the gag reflex. So, on the knuckles, you have scars because the incisors usually come into contact. That was bang on Russell sign, which is seen in bulimia nervosa. Now, let's see whether team 10 finishes on the great note with which we started. So, the last question in the spotter round. Identify the maneuver used to differentiate organic weakness from non-organic paresis of the limb. Team 10. Team 10. You have 18 seconds there, Team 10. Please unmute yourself, Team 10. Unmute yourself. 14 seconds.
Extension of the extension.
You gave us the right answer.
Hoover sign.
Hoover sign is the right answer. Well done, Team 10. That was indeed Hoover sign. So we come to the end of 5 rounds. We have 3 more to go, and now for the scores.
At the end of round 5, the leaders are Medicity Institute of Medical Sciences, Telangana, followed by second position, Maharaja Institute of Medical Sciences, AP, and Pushpagiri Medical College, Kerala, with 90 points.
Well done, teams. Now, we have 2 more themed rounds left. We go on to round 6 of the psychopharmacology. This is the psychopharmacology round, which is going to be a multiple choice question, which means there are going to be no passes. Now we start in an anti-clockwise manner. So the first question is going to be to team 10. Exposure to which of the following drug in utero can lead to the development of Epstein's anomaly in infants? And your options are A. Olanzapin, B. Lithium, C. Carbamazepin, or D. Flupentixol.
Now it's B. Lithium.
Yes. Team 10, you're absolutely right. You got it right. Lithium is the right answer. Full marks for you there. Now, we go over to Team 9. Which depot injection can produce the post-injection delirium sedation syndrome or the PDSS? Is it A. Olanzapin, B. Haloperidol, C. Flufenazine, or D. Flupentixol?
Ma'am, it's option D. Flupentixol.
Flupentixol is not the right answer, Team 9. The right answer was Olanzapin. Olanzapin is the right answer, which is post-injection delirium sedation syndrome is uniquely found in the Olanzapin palmovate preparation, where there is inadvertent intravascular entry of the drug into the bloodstream, and they develop within 1 hour, they can develop this. So that's Olanzapin was the right answer. Now, the question is for Team 8. Extrapyramidal symptoms are due to the blockade of dopamine 2 receptors in the following areas of the brain. Identify the pathway. Is it A. Nigrostriatal pathway? Is it B. Tuberofundibular pathway? Is it C. Mesolimbic pathway? Or D. Mesocortical pathway?
Option A. Nigrostriatal pathway.
Yes, you are right, Team A. It was the nigrostriatal pathway. You are right there. And now we move over to Team 7. Question number 4. Lorazepam challenge test is widely used to confirm the diagnosis of which of the following? Is it A. Catatonia, B. Schizophrenia, C. Bipolar affective disorder, or D. OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder? Team 7. 20 seconds there to go, Team 7. Your clock is ticking. You can make a wild guess there because there is no passes. Some MCQ.
MC.
No, C is not the right answer. The right answer is catatonia. Catatonia, lorazepam challenge test is used to confirm, usually they respond immediately when lorazepam is administered. Now, over to the fifth question to team 6. California rocket fuel is a combination of which of the following drugs? A. Sertraline and venlafaxine, B. Escitalopram and desvenlafaxine, C. Mirtazapine and venlafaxine, D. Bupropion and desvenlafaxine. Team 6.
Ma'am, C, ma'am.
Yes, C, mirtazapine and venlafaxine is the right answer. This was formulated by Dr. Stephen Stahl, and this is because of the strategic dynamic interaction between these two drugs. Very well done, team 6. C was the right option. Now over to team 5 for the sixth question. Which drug among the following produces a disulfiram-like reaction? And your options are A, mirtazapine, B, metronidazole, C, memantine, or D, melatonin.
Team B, metronidazole.
Metronidazole is indeed the right answer. Very, very well done. Team 5, the lone warrior there, who is a single participant. Right, you are right. Now we go on to team 4 for the seventh question. Which anesthetic agent is used in the treatment of severe depression? And your options are A. Amobarbital, B. Desflurane, C. Ketamine, or D. Methohexital. Team 4, what is your option? 20 seconds there for you. Team 4. No, amobarbital was not the right answer. The right answer is ketamine. So ketamine was the right answer. In sub-anesthetic doses, it is used as an antidepressant. It acts very rapidly, robustly, and intranasal forms have also been formulated. Now, over to team 3 for the 8th question. Which of the following antipsychotics has the likelihood of causing seizures? Your options are A. Clozapine, B. Risperidone, C. Lurasidone, or D. Aripiprazole. ¿20 seconds to go?
A. Clozapine.
Clozapine is the right answer. No hesitancy there. At doses of more than 600 milligram, clozapine can cause, and for rapid titration also, there is a risk of seizures with clozapine. You are right, team 3. Now for the second last question of the round, which goes to team 2. Identify the oral antipsychotic that can be given once a week. And your options are A. Zuclopentaxol, B. Haloperidol, C. Penfluridol, or D. Flupentaxol. Team 2.
Option C. Penfluridol.
Penfluridol is the right answer. You got it right. It has an extremely long elimination half-life of, any guesses there? 66 hours. So you got it right, team 2. Very well done. And for the last question of the psychopharmacology round, which goes to team 1. Vilazodone is SPARI. Expand S-P-A-R-I SPARI. Your options are serotonin partial antagonist reuptake inhibitor, B. Serotonin partial agonist reuptake inhibitor, C. Serotonin and norepinephrine agonist reuptake inhibitor, or D. Serotonin and norepinephrine antagonist reuptake inhibitor.
B.
B. Yes. Yes, you said the right answer. B is the right answer. Serotonin partial agonist reuptake inhibitor is the full form of SPARI. You got it right, team 1. So we have come to the end of six rounds. And let us see who is leading.
So right now, I think...
Louder, please. Yes.
Actually, the current scoreboard right now I think the Pushpagiri Medical College
and Maharaja Institute of Medical Sciences in the leading position, followed by Medicity Institute of Medical Science and Mysore Medical College is in the second position with 100 points.
Very well done. You can make up. There are two more rounds, the last of the themed round, and rapid fire you can definitely make up for all the teams who are a little upset. So now to the last of the themed round, which is going to be forensic psychiatry. Now this is going to be clockwise, so which means the first question will be to team one. Team one, the horrific Delhi gang rape case in which one of the accused was a few months younger than 18 years of age led to the amendment of an act under which he was tried in a special court. Name the act and the year it was first enacted. The year it was first enacted. There are two parts to this. It carries 10 plus 10. Team 1, what is your answer? Ten seconds there. Three seconds. Your time is...
Ma'am, Pauk's go, 2012.
Your time was up. That was not the right answer. Team 2, if the question passes to you.
Ma'am, a Pauk's go act in 2012.
No, that is not the right answer, Team 2. The right answer was the Juvenile Justice Act. And the year that it was first enacted, audience, 2000. And it was later amended after the Nirbhaya case. Now, over to Team 2. Name the section of the Mental Health Care Act 2017 that prevents seclusion or solitary confinement of mentally ill patients and lays down strict guidelines on the use of physical restraints in them. Name the section, Team 2. Team 2, you've got 16 seconds to go. Section of the Mental Health Care Act.
Section 87, ma'am.
No, that was not the right answer. The question passes to Team 3. 5 seconds there. Your time is
2A
up. No, the right answer was Section 97 of the Mental Health Care Act. Now over to Team 3 for the third question. According to this section of the Mental Health Care Act of 2017, suicide attempters are presumed to have severe stress not to be punished, and the government should have duty to provide care, treatment and rehabilitation to reduce the risk of recurrence. Name the section of the Mental Health Care Act that decriminalizes suicide in India. Team 3.
Section 309 is decriminalized.
That was a wrong answer. The question passes to Team 4. No, that was a wrong answer. The right answer is Section 115 that decriminalizes suicide. Now over to Team 4 for the fourth question. In the famous drugs on cruise ship case, the son of a famous Bollywood actor had been denied bail on the 20th of October. He had been invoked under which act, and name the year that it was enacted first, Team 4. The question is not the Bollywood actor, the question is about the act. 13 seconds there. There are two sections to the question. You can, even one, you score there. It was substance abuse, but you have to name the act. So the question passes to Team 5. Team 5?
Do you need... Narcotics, Drugs and Psychotropic Substance Act.
Yes, excellent. And do you know the year too, when it was first enacted?
Ma'am, 2002.
No, but you got half points for that. NDPS Act was absolutely right. It was first enacted in the year 1985. Well done there, Team 5. Now the question to team 5, right? On 9th March 2018, the Supreme Court of India ruled that individuals had a right to die with dignity, allowing for passive euthanasia. The decision was made as part of the verdict in a case involving a nurse who was in a permanent vegetative state following an assault in the hospital where she worked. Name this person.
Namo, Aruna Shanbhag.
Absolutely right, team 5. It was indeed Aruna Shanbhag case. She was a nurse and she apparently was in a vegetative state for 42 long years before she died due to pneumonia. So team 5, you were right there. Now the next question to team 6. In 1843 in England, this person shot and killed the secretary to the Prime Minister, Mr. Edwin Drummond, mistakenly identifying him as the then UK Prime Minister Robert Peel, who was actually the intended target. The person was eventually acquitted and this rule was formulated in reaction to his acquittal. Name the rule, team 6. The rule was named after the person. Team 6, 2 seconds.
McNaughton rule.
We'll give it to you, team 6. McNaughton's rule is the right answer. We move on to the second last question of the forensic round, which goes to, no, we have more questions there. Team 7. Team 7. Childline, initiated under the Union Ministry of Women and Child Development, is India's first 24-hour toll-free phone outreach service for children. What is the number for this helpline? Team 7.
1098.
Absolutely right. Team 7, 1098 is the right answer. For those who came by flight, I think the first banners which were there outside the airport was this child. And I thought somebody was giving out my question bank. So that was right. 1098 is the right answer. Now over to team 8. Team 8, expand the POKSO Act and in which year it was enacted. Two parts to this question. Expand POSCO. Team 8, make an attempt there. Seconds more. Try. You can try.
Against sexual offense.
Please be louder.
Protection of children from sexual offenses.
You are right there. Yes, and your team and your time is up. For the second part of the question, which passes to team 9, can you tell us in which year the POKSO Act was enacted? Team 8? Sorry, team 9.
2004.
2004 is not the right answer. The right answer was 2012. So team 8 got it right. POKSO is indeed the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act. Now for the second last question of the forensic round to team 9. Involuntary euthanasia of elderly by their own family members is observed in some parts of Tamil Nadu. The person is given an extensive oil bath early in the morning and subsequently made to drink glasses of tender coconut water, which results in kidney failure, high fever, seizures, and death within a day or two. Name the term that is used to describe this act. Team 9. Yes, your time is up. The question passes to team 10. Team 10?
Is it Thale Kootal?
Absolutely right. Absolutely right. That was Thale Kootal. Thalaikku Ootrathu. Thale Kootal. In English, it's also called the senicide or the gerontocide. So, very well done, team 10. That was team 9. That was supposed to be a difficult question and you did extremely well there. And now for the final question of the forensic round, which goes to team 10. The Vishakha guidelines was framed by the Supreme Court during the verdict of a case of a social worker from Rajasthan who was brutally gang raped. This laid the foundation for an important act that puts the onus of safe working environment on the employer. Name the act, Team 10.
Guidelines.
20 seconds there. Name the act. Safe working environment. A guess there. Do you want to take a guess? You have 5 seconds more.
Disha.
Your time is up. The question passes to team one. Team one.
Prevention of Sexual Abuse at Workplace Act. POSH Act.
Yes, POSH. What does a H stand for?
Harassment.
Yes. So I gave you the clue, but that was Prevention of Sexual Harassment at Workplace Act. We'll give it to you, Team 1, which was enacted in 2013. That was the POSH Act. So we've come to the end of the 7 themed rounds. You've done extremely well. Let's gear up for the final round of rapid fire. And here are the scores.
The second place is shared by Maharaja Institute of Medical Science and Pushpagiri Medical College. Excellent job.
Do you want a 2 second break? Because this rapid fire round, I'm going to ask you 5 questions and you'll have to answer within 60 seconds. So no waiting, no halting, no pauses. Please be crisp with your answers. And how we are going to do it is that the colors on the screen, please. 60. So now what we are going to have here is the colors you can see displayed on the screen. Yes. So we'll start this with clockwise. Team 1 will go first. You choose a color. And then here we have cards which are different colored, and each card contains a set of 5 questions, and I will pick up the card the color that you have chosen. Is that okay? Now shall we start? You can give me the colors. Yes, you want to please give me this a little. Okay, team 1, do you want to choose your color?
I'm brown.
Which one? Actually, that was, sorry, that was maroon, but it's okay. Shall we start the timer? Your question starts now. Who created the theory of transactional analysis? Yawning is a common withdrawal feature of which substance?
Copy.
Wrong answer. Brickett syndrome is currently known as what? We'll pass. District mental health program in India was first implemented where?
Bangalore?
No. The last question. Name the condition where a woman falsely believes that she is pregnant.
Syndrome. What syndrome?
No, that's not the right answer.
Pseudo.
There are no passes. There are no passes here. So if you want to go on to the next question, please say pass. We'll go on to the next question. And are they allowed to come back to the question later? If there is time, you can come back to the question. Is that okay? And here, I'll just tell you the answers. The theory of transactional analysis was Eric Byrne. And yawning is a common withdrawal feature of opioids. Brickett syndrome is somatization disorder. And DMHP program was in Bellary district. And pseudocyesis was the right answer for the last one. So now we go on to team two. Please go on to choose your color.
One pink color.
You've chosen pink. Your choice of questions, your timer starts now. Self-actualization as a concept was introduced by whom?
Asthma.
Coprolalia is an integral feature of which disorder?
Coprolalia. Asthma.
What are the waves in the EEG recording in awake state but with eyes closed called as?
Alpha waves.
Right. Psychological pillow is seen in which condition?
Oh, catatonia.
Right. Wernicke's encephalopathy occurs due to the deficiency of which vitamin?
Vitamin B2. Thiamine.
Thiamine is the right answer. You want to go back to your first question?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Self-actualization as a concept was introduced by whom?
Self-actualization.
Asthma. Coprolalia is an integral feature.
Tourette's
is the right answer. So, yes, I think we've got it there. Very well done, team two. Now shall we move on to team three? So the answer for the first question, self-actualization, was Abraham Maslow. Team three, please make your pick.
Blue.
And your set of questions starts now. Who coined the term dementia praecox?
Emil Kraepelin.
Right. Name the law that states recent memories are more likely to be lost than remote memories. Neglect and squalor behavior in the elderly is referred to as which syndrome? The first presentation of a tumor can be depression. Name the tumor. Madras longitudinal study was done on which illness?
What study, ma'am?
Madras longitudinal study was done in which illness?
Schizophrenia.
Schizophrenia is the right answer. We'll go back to your name the law that states recent memories are more likely to be lost than more remote memories.
Law.
Next. Neglect and squalor behavior in the elderly is referred to as which syndrome?
Next.
The first presentation of a tumor can be depression.
Frontal lobe.
No, wrong. That was pancreatic cancer. And the law that states that recent memories are more likely to be lost than remote memories is called Ribot's law. R-I-B-O-T. And the squalor is the Diogenes syndrome. Diogenes. Now over to team 4, please make your pick on the colors which are left behind.
Yellow color, ma'am.
Team 4 is here, okay. Shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Name the Indian psychiatrist who received the Ramen Magsaysay Award in 2018.
Pass.
What is the name of the condition where the expectant father experiences some of the same symptoms as his pregnant wife?
Coarsin.
Right. In which stage of sleep do sleep spindles and K waves appear?
Second. NREM2.
Excellent. The hallucinations which are experienced outside the sensory field limit are called as?
Extracampal hallucinations.
Right. Nicotine replacement for smoking cessation can be given in all forms except? You have time. You have enough time to think. Nicotine replacement can be given in all forms except?
Injection.
Right, we'll give it there. Intravenous.
First.
And the first, name the Indian psychiatrist who received the Ramen Magsaysay Award in 2018.
Mrs. Sharada?
No, that was a wrong answer. Open to the audience. Dr. Bharat Vatwani is the right answer. So very well done, team 4. I think you got 4 out of 5. Excellent going there. We'll move over to team 5. 5, please make your pick of color. Team 5,
I'm can red.
You? Yes, red. Red. Team 5, shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Who is credited for the camp approach for psychiatry in India? He put up tents in the hospital compound so that the family could stay with the patients.
Dr. Vidyasagar.
Right. Magnum sign is related to the addiction of which substance?
Cocaine.
The term post-traumatic stress disorder came into use following which war?
Vietnam War.
Excellent. The part of the mind which works on the moral principle is called?
Can you repeat the question?
The part of the mind which works on the moral principle is called?
Ma'am, superego.
Excellent. Inability to identify and describe emotions experienced by one's self is called?
Alexithymia.
You got all 5 there, team 5. Excellent. Excellent. Now we move over to team 6 to make your pick of color.
Ma'am, white.
White. Team 6 goes with white. And shall we start your 5 questions now? Your first question. First rank symptoms of schizophrenia were proposed by whom?
Pass.
Voges triad is seen in which genetic disease that presents with neuropsychiatric symptoms? You can say a pass and come back again.
I'm Voges-Coyangi.
That was the wrong answer. The inverse relationship between anxiety and performance is described by an inverted U-shaped curve. What is it called? Teeth grinding and jaw clenching in sleep.
I'm next.
Teeth grinding and jaw clenching in sleep is called as?
Oh, ma'am, next.
Agranulocytosis can be the fatal complication of which antipsychotic?
Ma'am, we couldn't hear.
Agranulocytosis can be the fatal complication of which? Anyway, your time is up. We'll go to the answers. The first rank symptoms of schizophrenia were proposed by Kurt Schneider. Voges triad is seen in tuberous sclerosis. The question came up in another round. The inverse relationship between anxiety and performance is called the Yerkes-Dodson law. And teeth grinding and jaw clenching is called bruxism. Agranulocytosis is a fatal complication of clozapine. So, anyway, now we'll go on to team 7. Team 7, please make your pick of colors.
Orange.
Orange. Orange. Team 7 is present here. So, shall we start your questions? What does thanatophobia mean?
Fear of death.
Right. Social classification of suicide was given by?
Emil Durkheim.
Right. Reversible dementia is caused by the deficiency of which vitamin?
B12.
Right. Filling up gaps by fabricating to cover lapses in memory is called?
Confabulation.
Right. Electra complex was first described by?
Jung.
That was the wrong answer.
Erickson.
That's the wrong answer. We can't give it there. You did exceedingly well. If you had listened, you would have answered. I mean, if you had thought, you would have answered. The right answer was Sigmund Freud, who gave the Electra complex and the Oedipus complex as well. So we have 3 more teams and with which we wind up the quiz. And now for team 8 to make their pick of color.
Pink.
Okay, that was supposed to be purple. It's okay. Are you ready, team 8? Team 8, are you ready? Ready?
Ma'am, it's green, ma'am.
What? You wanted green?
Yes, ma'am.
You won't be allowed to change your choices, okay?
No, you couldn't hear us, ma'am.
You couldn't hear? Purple could have been luckier. It's okay. So now, over to team 8 for your set of 5 questions. Who coined the term hysteria?
Pass.
Pronoun reversal is classically seen in which childhood disorder?
Ma'am, repeat ma'am.
Pronoun reversal is classically seen in which childhood disorder?
Pass.
Yes?
Pass, ma'am.
Pass. The first general hospital psychiatry unit was started in which Indian city?
Pass.
Pass. The symptom of inability to enjoy previously pleasurable activities is known as?
Anhedonia.
Right. 10 by 66 research group is related to which condition or illness?
Hysteria.
First question, who coined the term hysteria?
Sigmund Freud.
Wrong. Pronoun reversal is classically seen in which childhood disorder?
Autism.
Right. The first general hospital psychiatry unit was started in which Indian city?
Lucknow.
Your time is up. So the answers were, Hippocrates coined the term hysteria, and the first general hospital psychiatry unit was started in Kolkata in 1933 by Dr. G.S. Bose, and 10 by 66 research group is related to dementia. Mm-hmm. Now to team 9, you have only two choices left.
Purple, ma'am.
Purple. So, are you ready, team 9?
Yes, ma'am.
Team 9 is here. Team 9 is here. We start. The name Anthony T. Barker is associated with what in psychiatry?
Pass, ma'am.
What is common to hyperventilation, sleep deprivation, and photic stimulation?
Neuroleptic malignancy.
Wrong answer. What is the number of Wernicke's area according to Brodmann's classification?
Pass, ma'am.
False feeling of unfamiliarity with a real situation that a person has experienced is known as?
Jamaisu.
Right. Finger agnosia, dyscalculia, and right-left disorientation is seen in which condition?
Gustman syndrome.
That's right.
Ma'am, repeat the questions.
The first question. The name Anthony T. Barker is associated with what in psychiatry?
Next.
What is common to hyperventilation, sleep deprivation, and photic stimulation? I think you got that answer wrong, so we can't repeat it. Number of Wernicke's area according to Brodmann's classification?
40-41 area.
Time is up. That was a wrong answer.
No, actually, you got it started 10 seconds late.
But we'll give it because I repeated 40. It. Do you have the answer?
40-41.
That was the wrong answer. So that was area 22. And what is common to hyperventilation, sleep deprivation, and photic stimulation? They are activation procedures which we use in EEG, electroencephalogram. And the name Anthony T. Barker is associated with TMS, transcranial magnetic stimulation. I think the others you got it right. Now we go to the final team. Team 10, you don't get to choose.
Yes, ma'am.
Your color is gray. Team 10 is... Team 10. Are you ready?
Ma'am.
Let's see.
Yes,
I would want you to finish the quiz on a grand note by answering 5 out of 5. Get ready, all of you. Who gave the concept of operant conditioning?
B.F. Skinner.
Right. Concept of pandas is related to which psychiatric disorder?
Beta hemolytic streptocoque, neuropsychiatric.
Is related to which psychiatric disorder is the question?
Pass.
Bhang, an edible preparation, is derived from the leaves of which plant?
Erythroxylum coca.
Wrong. Mm-hmm. Personality disorder in chronic epileptics is known as?
Pass. Pass.
What is the theme of the World Mental Health Day 2021?
First question.
We can't go back because you already gave wrong answers.
We didn't answer.
You didn't answer. What is the theme of the World Mental Health Day 2021?
Before question.
Personality disorder and chronic epileptics. 2 seconds. No. Time is up. So the right answers, the concept of pandas, you were able to expand, that occurs in OCD. That occurs with OCD, and bhang, an edible preparation, is derived from the leaves of cannabis sativa. That's ganja. So personality disorder in chronic epileptics is Jastorf-Jeschwin syndrome. And the theme of the World Mental Health Day 2021, we finished the quiz on that note. Mental health in an unequal world. So we as doctors, I think, all the undergraduates here, let's create equality in choosing our specialities as well. Let's have more of psychiatrists and let us make mental health equal in an unequal world. Thank you. And now let us give a few minutes to the scorers so that they will come up with the results of the winners of the IPSACON South Zone quiz competition. A few seconds. Okay, the results are ready.
Start with the third.
Yeah.
Okay.
There are three teams in third position. The first one is ESIC Medical College, Chennai. Second one is GMC Calicut, Kerala, and Maharaja Institute of Medical Sciences, AP. So the runners up for this quiz is SS Institute of Medical Sciences, Karnataka. And winner of IPSACON 2021 quiz is from Mysore Medical College, Karnataka. Thank you.
I thank you once again for all of you who participated. Kudos to the winners. You were all very, really, really very, very close. So I think that's what all the, you were very close. You all did extremely well. I thank the audience for also participating. Thank you once again, and we come to the end of the program. Thank you.
Thank you all. Now I welcome Dr. Rajaram to deliver the memento to the jurors.